Welcome back to another edition of CAD Jungle. As a reminder, if you like this content, please don't hesitate to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you can be notified anytime I put out new videos. Now, in today's episode, we're going to be creating this object here. Let's get started. Let's start out by creating a new component. Select the top view. Create a sketch on the visible plane. And let's start out by creating a center diameter circle. Let's add some dimensions. Select the E key, because we're going to extrude this circle we just created. We're going to extrude it about 2 millimeters. We're going to create a sketch on the top face. I'm going to add another center diameter circle and also add dimensions. Once again, select the E key, select extrusion command. We're going to select 3 millimeters as the height. Once again, we'll create a sketch on this face. We're going to use the center diameter circle and add dimensions as well. Finish the sketch. I'm going to use the extrude command. Select the profile we just created. One extruded 8 millimeters. Next, we're going to rotate to the bottom. I'm going to create a construction plane on this bottom face. I want to rotate it inward about 7 millimeters. Next, we're going to create a sketch on this plane we just created. We're going to create a center diameter circle in the center. Make it 26 millimeters. Finish the sketch. We're going to select the extrude command once again. We're going to extrude the circle 2.5 millimeters inside. I'm going to select the front view. And next, I'm going to go to Inspect, Section Analysis, and I'm going to select the inside plane, rotate it to flip it, and you can see what we just did. We actually cut a slot on the inside with that profile. Okay, I'm going to turn off Analysis. And what I'm going to do now, create a sketch on this face. I'm going to create the profile to set these up here. Let's use the two-point rectangle. Make it a construction line. Let's add some dimensions. Only want to add a dimension to the top. And here's why. First things first, I'm going to use the midpoint constraint. Select the bottom. Select the center point, and next I'm going to use the tangent constraint. Select the top edge of the circle. All right, this is going to be my guide. So what I want to do now is create a circular pattern, and I want to choose the rectangle I just created. Center point is going to be the center point that it'll rotate around, and I want the quantity to be 3. And now we can go ahead and set up our profile, make sure the construction is turned off. And so on the inside, I'm going to start from here to here. It locks into place. And we're going to continue to draft this outline. Now that that's set, let's use the offset command and begin to select the profiles as follows. I'm actually going to turn off chain selection. Once again, select the lines. And we're going to make it 5 millimeters. I'm going to do this once again for the other two. And that should be a negative, so it'll go on the outside. And it's set. Let's go ahead and finish the sketch. Let's use the extrude command. Select the profiles we just created. Let's go ahead and extrude it about 19 millimeters. Let's add some fillets. First things first, let's add some fillets to the inside. We'll make this about 5 millimeters. Add another selection set by hitting the plus symbol here. Select the inside edges, and we make these 3 millimeters. Let's rotate the top view. Let's create a sketch in the center. So let's just add a construction circle. It's going to be our guide. We're going to make it about 50 millimeters. Let's add a construction line. We're going to put it down the center. Well, actually, let me go ahead and rotate this. All right, orientation is correct. Center to the bottom. Add another line to this point here. And I want this to be 15 degrees from the center. Let's go ahead and finish the sketch. Select the whole command. Select this point. And let's go ahead and add the parameters as follows. I'm going to drag this up. Set the distance to all. It's going to be countersunk. I want the width, top width, to be 9.5 millimeters. I want the height from the countersink to be 4.6 millimeters. I want the bottom width to be 5.5 millimeters. It didn't go all the way through, so let me go back and correct by editing the feature. It's supposed to be 5.5, not 0.5. Now it's correct. All right, let's create a sketch. Let's put it on this face here. Zoom in. Let's add a center diameter circle in space, make it 6 millimeters. Let's dimension it evenly from the corner, 8 millimeters in that direction, 8 millimeters in this direction. Locked into place, finish the sketch. Let's go ahead and select extrude command. One side distance, I want two object. As a matter of fact, we'll just go ahead and make it all. Let's go ahead and use circular pattern command. Object type is going to be features. Select the extrusion we just created, as well as the hole we created. Axis, we can go ahead and just select this rounded edge of the body. I want it to be of quantity of 3. Adjust is good. Click OK. Let's go ahead and create a sketch at the top here. Select the center diameter circle. Make it 20 millimeters. Hit the E key for extrude. Select the profile we just created. extend type is going to be to object. I'm going to make it go all the way through. Last but not least, let's go ahead and add some chamfers. Select these edges here. Make these 4 millimeters. And congratulations, that completes this project. Well, I hope you like this quick exercise. Stick around and I'll see you in the next video.